They've just been asking questions, Mommy. Most of them just practical.
Practical? Stuff. That's good. Asking practical questions is very good.
Would you like to talk to them for a while and just...
I first talk to them, then ask their questions in person. I'm overjoyed to see you all here. Actually, the whole night I was working on Melbourne seekers, that they should come today and should establish their realization very well. Now, we have to understand few things about Sahajayoga very clearly, and there is no compromise on these few things that we have to accept. Because as I told you, truth cannot compromise for you, you have to compromise for truth. So the first is that Sahajayoga is not just a precept, it's not just a precept, it is practice. It's not just a mental idea. Now you've got realization, all right. But it's not sufficient. Even if you think that you've got realization, so now you are all right, you become the spirit, all right. But still it is more a mental conception than the real identification. So it is not that if you become your realization, if you get your realization and you starts the awakening of the Kundalini starts very well, still it is to be understood that it is the practice of Sahajayoga which is much more important than the precepts of it. There are many people in India who can't read or write, who don't have all these mental activities as you have. They are not so complicated as you are. Some of them are aboriginal people, just living in the villages, very simple people. They get realization. They feel the joy much faster than the complicated ones feel, and they just start working on it. You have to work it out. This is not a compassion that speaks, talks, elaborates and advertises, but it works. Sahajayoga is a thing that works, the religion that works. And this is what we must understand first of all, that it is not the talking, it is not the precept that you are a great soul, you have to become. Not that you are not, you are, but you have to be aware of it. More light has to flow into you. Definitely you must be something special to get it, no doubt. But you must allow your lamp to be cleared out, cleansed, so that more light is given. And it works wonders for people who honestly want to ascend in spirituality. As I told you before also, that it is a concept many people have, that Sahajayoga cures people. It's not true. It just as a byproduct, it may cure you. Just as a byproduct. So, one has to understand the blessing has come to you only because you are a seeker, you have done lots of good in your past lives and this life also, and that God has chosen you to be in His kingdom. But it cannot be demanding, you cannot demand. You can't demand anything from God. He has to give you because He knows what you deserve. And He gives you much, much, much more than what you deserve. I mean, I've seen people who have been in Sahajayoga that after 1 year they start asking, Mother, what did we do to deserve all this? They just can't believe it. I said, it must be something. You must know that there must be something, that the blessings have come to you. This is one thing one has to understand, that you cannot make Sahajayoga compromise for you. You have to understand all the techniques and things about Sahajayoga. Now the thing could be that you may start doubting. You see, so that's what we have people who are doubting about it and doing all kinds of things. You see, in the beginning they are rather slow movers. So we have to sort them out to begin with, because the second stage of awareness is doubtless awareness. You are doubtless about yourself, doubtless about the working of Sahajayoga, doubtless about God's existence, doubtless about His laws. You become absolutely doubtless, not mentally, but it's a state of your being, by which you achieve lots of results and you really become powerful then. You can see your compassion so powerful, so discreet, so understanding, so forbearing, and you are amazed at yourself. You really become a saint in the real sense of the word, that you become humble, flowering beautifully, not taking anything aggressive on your, upon yourself, and you are really in the kingdom of God, that you feel that you are looked after, protected, guided, blessed every moment you walk along. And that's the state everybody should aspire to reach, is the doubtless awareness. And unless until you reach that state, we don't call you Sahajayogi. You may start calling yourself, but that's left to yourself, you see. There are no sort of, we don't have any certification or things going on, or we do not give any written certificates to people, nothing of the kind. It is you who has to certify yourself. So, gradually people grow up into beautiful beings. They start having their self-esteem fully established, understanding themselves. But practice of Sahajayoga must be done without thinking too much about it. First you just try it, worth trying, because if you start doubting, I tell you, your progress will be much less. So first, just like a scientist, you try to accept one by one. There's nothing has to be done, I mean, don't have to pay me anything, of course, that goes. You don't have to do any acrobatics or anything. But for example, a small thing like my photograph, you see, many people say, why your photograph? So use your photograph, I say. If that works out, you see, it's something surprising. That's how people challenge me. Why your photograph? I say, why not use yours? I'll be very happy, use anybody's. But it doesn't work out. What to do now? It's my photograph that works out, but even if you don't like it, you have to use it. What can I do? It's as simple as that, you see. But in that, I don't gain anything from you. I don't want anything from you. Nothing material that you can give me. But you'll enjoy. You'll enjoy my love. You'll enjoy. It's all for your own enjoyment, everything is done. And this is a special time we are born in, we have a special responsibility. Today we had a lady who came, her husband came, and they were saying that they had a son who was very well equipped, and he went to one of the gurus and he got completely ruined. And this particular guru, we have to be rather careful about, is this Rajneesh fellow. His disciples are rather difficult. They come to Sahajayoga, all right, but they are very extreme type of people. They come with a great force to Sahajayoga, again go back. So all those who have been to Rajneesh and have taken his initiation have to be extremely careful. All of you who have been to gurus must know that they will be again and again attacked. So you have to be rather patient with yourself, as we are with you, and must know that you must assert your willpower a little bit to come up and shed off all that was screwed into your head, and you paid for it, you see. So forget it. Sometimes people say that we have paid for it, so better have it. That's not the way. You better throw it away. It's horrible. You have bought a snake on your head, on your neck. So just throw away all these things that they have put you on. Forget it and become yourself, first of all. Become your own guru. Ask your vibrations, develop your vibratory awareness and grow with it. Some people will find also that their vibrations are not showing very good results. Some of you will find that kind of thing. And when you find that your vibrations are not working out in your hands and things, you should not get worried about it. Maybe your Vishuddhi chakra is not all right. There are ways and methods of improving Vishuddhi chakra by which you know the exact mantras to be said and how to improve it. And we have also vibrated oil and all that you can apply here. And also there are other methods by which you can improve your sinus. And if you have any problem with the Vishuddhi because of over-smoking or anything, there are so many ways which you can call the grandmother's medicines, simple, simple things, which will work it out, should try to clear out. So whatever center is not working out, you should get after that. And don't worry about the centers that are good, because those who are good are good. So we have to look after the centers which are in trouble and try to improve our centers and the complete being is to be brought to the balance. Some people have some centers so badly off that despite the fact they have all the centers all right, because of one center, you see, they are in imbalance. So first thing in Sahajayoga is to establish a balance. Now certain things about morality and all that, I don't want to talk to you. Gradually yourself realize what is good for you and bad for you. But in Sahajayoga, you will be given a proper guidance as to what is to be done, how to lead a life and how to have a normal, good married life, how to have children, how to look after them, how to get to your parents. So the social side also you can learn very well, by which you really feel happy. But the main society that you have is of Sahajayogis. Of course, you don't have to cut off from anyone, you don't have to give up anyone. But you grow among your Sahajayogis. These are called as Sajjanas, see, Sajjana, the people who are the followers of truth. So once you come together, it's a collective happening, it works out more collectively and it helps you much more. But if you say individually, Mother, I can do it, it doesn't work out. In Sahajayoga, I've seen you don't go too far. You all have to work it together, you have to meet. Luckily, you have a very good ashram here. You all can come and meditate and take a proper help from these people. God has already blessed this place so much. And when I came to Melbourne, I stayed in a very small little house with, I think, 2 bedrooms and some sort of a thing like that. And this time I find a big, huge thing being given to you, and they may start also a nice school for small children here. Your small children can go to that school where they can be looked after well, they won't have any complications. And everything can be done at a much better level than what you find in the mundane life. Everything has a meaning, spiritual meaning. Everything in life has a meaning. So you should try to find out whatever is good for your ascent and for your nourishing of your spiritual being. I hope next time when I come, all of you will be great Sahajayogis and will be great people. Individually, everyone will be working out on many people, and we have to change the face of Melbourne completely. May God bless you all.